another ASMR video. What's going on? As you can see, I got a whole chicken. It's pretty massive. It's pretty big. I know it looks dark, but basically, the seasoning I use, I made this, by the way. It is a mixture of one of my favorite dry rubs, which is called tequila lime, and I mixed it with some Cajun blackened seasoning, and it wouldn't be full-on, you know, full-on Cajun blackened if it's not blackened. So as you can see, it's very dark, but I assure you, I checked the temperature and it was at a beautiful 165 degrees, nice and done, so it should be nice and juicy inside. I think I'm gonna, it looks nicer on this side. Nah, it looks about the same. I love the skin when it's like black and crispy and really just ready to go. There's an old Ignited ASMR video I watched where he ate a whole entire rotisserie chicken. And I remember he had it with like tortillas, because he was like, I can't eat a whole chicken with like no kind of bread or nothing like that. I'm the same way. I can't just eat a whole chicken like somebody we know, without like some kind of like side, some kind of bread or some kind of anything. So I did bring some cornbread, and I got some butter to go with it as well. And of course, like always, deserve to see this massiveness. I don't think I'll be able to eat the whole thing, obviously, but you never know. You never know. Yo, I shaved my head. Got me a little haircut. Anyways, alright, let's get into it. I'm gonna start like this. Yo, this skin is amazing. Yeah, when I made this, when I made this rotisserie, I'm pretty much just like, everything. I put tons of flavor all up on this chicken. Somebody in the comments recently said, I better stop eating the way I'm eating, or I'm gonna be fat again. That was so sweet, because you're insinuating in so many words that I'm skinny. Now, when I saw that, I was just like, I'm gonna get fat again. I'm still a big dude. Like, what are you talking about? So you saying I'm skinny? Okay, I see you. I see you. More butter, please. This is pretty much how much I've covered. Yeah, this side is pretty murdered out. I hate most of the wing, the leg, the eye, and the eye. I'm working on the titties. Oh, by the way, thanks for all the feedback on my fried bologna egg sandwich video I did like 2 videos ago. I know I got a little like risque on it, and it wasn't like I wasn't even talking that bad. It was just a subject that I was talking about with somebody. And you know, whenever you talk about politics, religion, sex, relationships, it's always a very interesting subject. And I used to talk about those things a lot on my channel. I don't know why I haven't in a while. I mean, I don't know if you want me to, but if there's anybody out there that has any questions or has a particular topic they want me to talk about, I'll be more than happy to maybe do it. I mean, I don't know. Those type of videos are fun, like the one I just did a couple videos ago. But they're definitely one of those, like, it has to be, like, on a whim. I have to be in the mood for it. And it was early in the morning, and it just came out. I feel like those type of topics are fun to talk about. Because a lot of people can relate. I know I've had my fair share of crazy women, and you know what's funny about that? Women hate to be called crazy, like more so than bitch, the C word. Like, but the second you call them crazy, run. Relationships back a few months back. One of my favorite subjects is talking about how when you're younger, you know, you people tend to wear their heart on their sleeve more often. As you get older, you get more cynical. And then the older you get, the more cynical you get, the more people say things like, don't let past relationships affect your new ones. It's like, yeah, fucking easier said than done. I mean, you're not gonna go up to an accident victim. Like, you're not gonna go up to a person that's been in, like, a horrible car crash and be like, yo, let's go on a road trip. You drive in. And they're like, I was in a really tragic, like, I'm not down to drive. And you're like, yo, don't let the past situations affect you now, yo. Man up, stop being a bitch. Like, you're not gonna do that. And to me, in my opinion, relationships are fucking hardcore, man. To just open yourself up to somebody, to me, is fucking ridiculous. And you're setting yourself up for a lot of hurt. And yeah, I'm doing it, but it's scary as shit. So for somebody to belittle it and say, like, don't let your pet, like, I understand when you're in a new relationship, I get it, that new person does not deserve, like, for you to treat them a certain way. I definitely understand that, but for that other person to just look at you and be like, your past relationships affect us now. It's like, yo, that's fucking easier than done when nine times out of ten, y'all been doing this, that, every time I'm in a relationship. Like, some bullshit happens. And what you come through, and like, you ain't gonna do it. Like, out of all these other chicks that have done, or dudes, or whatever the case may be in your situation, now you want me to be like, ah, now you the one. You don't think they did the same shit? You don't think they were, you don't think every single one of these other, like, people said to you in your eyes, I would never hurt you, you the one, you this, you that, and then what? We sitting here single for a reason. And I remember talking about, I don't remember which video that was, but I remember talking about that. And I got a lot of flack for that. But I feel like it's such a true. It's some real shit, you feel me? Oh, stop talking so much, you need, motherfucker. For changing, I don't know, these are things that, like, I would like to start talking about.